Good morning. Welcome to the forecast discussion for September 12th, 2012. It is currently 7:42 a.m. and we are dealing with another beautiful morning. Temperatures range from the lower to mid 40s over the northern interior around northwestern Connecticut, the southern Hudson River Valley, and of course around northeastern Pennsylvania, to the upper 40s to lower 50s right around the New York City metropolitan area and mid to upper 50s along the coast. So, what could we expect for today? Well, take yesterday, rinse, repeat, pretty much. High pressure is in control, winds are light and variable, temperatures will rebound nicely into the mid to upper 70s over the interior and upper 70s to lower 80s over much of the coast and in urban locations. For the most part, we're dealing with another beautiful, pleasant day with humidity remaining very low with our dew points in the mid 40s to lower 50s. Also notice clear skies throughout the entire region, except for one location in southwestern Connecticut, where we do have a little bit of fog. Taking a look at the latest infrared satellite picture, you can see high pressure is in full control throughout the entire East Coast, providing very, very comfortable weather conditions and also clear skies. This cold front right here is actually going to weaken, and by the time it reaches the northern mid-Atlantic on Sunday, it looks like now that the air mass is going to be dry enough to only produce a few scattered clouds and not any rainfall. So it looks like Sunday is going to be dry. Monday also looks like it's going to be dry, but Tuesday, maybe not so much. We'll have to keep an eye on that. But overall, you can see our weather pattern is very quiet and will remain so throughout this entire week. And a quick look at the water vapor satellite picture, and you can see dry air is dominating much of the eastern United States. We have one disturbance over the Gulf Coast that won't do much, produce a little bit more cloud cover, maybe a few scattered showers along the Gulf Coast. And we have a northwesterly flow aloft that is basically what's called convergence aloft that's going to enhance the surface high pressure system. So again, really not much going on here. So let's take a look at the latest model guidance. This is from the Penn State EWOL website, and this is of course the European model guidance. So when you have high pressure in control, it really doesn't matter whether you use the GFS or the European model guidance at this point, because well, both models say not much is going on. So for this evening, high pressure again is in control, but notice that it is shifted off the coast now, and that's going to allow us to warm up just a little bit, pushing our temperatures to around 80 degrees for this afternoon and also for tomorrow afternoon. Now our cold front's going to move through late Saturday night through Sunday, and again, that's really not going to produce much in the way of precipitation for two reasons. One, the majority of lifting is going to be focused in the St. Lawrence River Valley, and two, there really isn't much moisture in the air. If you don't have much moisture in the air, well, you're not really going to get much of a potential for a shower or a thunder shower. So what we can expect on Sunday morning is just a little bit increase in cloud cover, a shift in the winds from the southwest to the northwest at 5 miles per hour, and a fall off in our temperatures on Sunday back off into the upper 70s. So really not really that much of a big change. We're looking instead of upper 70s to lower 80s, mid to upper 70s on Sunday with, again, dry conditions in place. And that high pressure system is going to remain in control through Monday with, once again, tranquil weather conditions. So really, this is a very quiet weather pattern in place. By Tuesday, we see a trough starting to dig into the eastern United States. Overall, the entire upper level pattern is starting to shift towards a trough around the Aleutian Islands, a ridge over the west coast, and a trough over the eastern two-thirds of the nation. And this is something we're going to keep an eye on, is this ridge starting to build up into Greenland and into northeastern Canada. That is what you call a negative NAO pattern. And that is going to be something to keep an eye on as we move on through the fall and winter seasons. But for Tuesday, it looks like this trough digs in, and we're going to see increasing potential for showers. Now, what's going to be interesting to watch is that we're going to have another tropical storm or hurricane starting to lift up through the northern Atlantic. This one's going to be Nadine. Now, Nadine's currently developing to the over the central Atlantic. It is tracking to the northwest and should move between a ridge over the western Atlantic and the trough over the east coast. So it won't directly impact the east coast, but we've got to see whether some residual moisture might get entrained into this low pressure system and this trough overall to produce a more widespread rainfall event. something to keep an eye on as we move into Tuesday. Wednesday and Thursday of next week, high pressure is in control, but we're going to see more disturbances, so a little bit better chance of a few scattered showers. But notice our overall pattern. Trough around the Aleutians, ridge on the west coast, deep trough over the eastern United States, and a ridge building into Greenland and into northeastern Canada. This is a cool weather pattern for the eastern United States. Now, the models might be jumping the gun a little bit, moving a little bit faster than what will actually happen, but you kind of get the point here of where we're going here with the overall pattern for at least the fall. Something to keep an eye on as we move forward. So that is your forecast discussion for today. Of course, I'm your meteorologist, Stephen DiMartino. You can follow the latest weather information at nynjpaweather.com and nynjpaweather on Twitter and Facebook. And you can get premium discussions for only $10 a month at nynjpaweather.com. Have a wonderful day. Stay safe out there.